This is part 2 of how to attend a lecture, and don't forget to see part 1 of this particular presentation. If you want to maintain very good academic record, then it is necessary that you attend the lectures 100%, and for that it is very necessary that you remain fit during your complete academic calendar period. Hence, to remain fit in your daily timetable, keep space of at least 45 minutes for exercise regime of your liking. To remain fit, another thing you have to remember is, do not leave house without very good breakfast in the morning. And remember that a vehicle or a human body cannot move without fuel. Your brain has to work during the whole day for academic activities. And another thing you have to remember is, brain takes nearly 85% of energy derived from food while studying. One survey conducted by Health Department of Government of India indicates that more than 50% students in India are suffering from anemia. And you cannot study well if you are anemic, since cells of your body will not get sufficient oxygen to derive energy, because red blood cells have got hemoglobin which carry hemoglobin. See, the slide on the left hand side is normal and the cells contain good hemoglobin, while in anemia, see how the cells appear almost empty. Hence, at the beginning of the academic year, by consulting your family physician, get following reports: complete blood count CBC and erythrocyte sedimentation rate. By CBC report and ESR report, it is possible to find out if you are suffering from anemia or any infection. In that case, you will not be able to concentrate on your studies, you will get easily tired. And if any health problem is there, then take complete treatment and become fit before an academic calendar starts. Eat sufficient food during the day according to the advice of your parents, teachers and family physician, and drink only safe water and maintain good personal hygiene to remain fit during your academic calendar. If at all, if you eat outside food, then see to it that you avoid the foods that are not heated, like chutney. By maintaining 100% attendance requirement, you will be able to improve your academic performance very well, so that you will be able to choose an institute of your liking in future, as well as any subject of your liking. And the very important feature of attending 100% is that will develop the ability in you to remain committed to any task 100%. Now I will give you tips again on how to attend a lecture. For that, let us consider a lecture on iron deficiency anemia and how you will go about it. Before attending this lecture, you must have very good knowledge of chemistry of red blood cells, chemistry of hemoglobin, and then maturation of red blood cells and information on anemia. And you won't ask any questions related to these topics to your teacher. Now listen to the following points carefully and also take notes. Foods rich in iron. absorption of iron in the intestine, transport systems of iron, iron deposition in the tissues, normal iron metabolism, risk factors for iron deficiency, and laboratory tests for the detection of iron deficiency anemia. And then at the end of the lecture, when it is your turn to ask questions, some questions must come to your mind, like why stool and urine examination is necessary to treat iron deficiency anemia, then why lime juice is beneficial in food therapy of iron deficiency anemia, and iron binding capacity test determines which blood component. Then think about presenting a paper during a seminar or any upcoming conference, like a paper on prevalence of iron deficiency anemia in students living in Hartmann area. Like that, many such topics may come to your mind if you attend lecture properly. Thank you very much, and don't forget to subscribe and share my channel Praful Godkar educational videos with all your classmates and friends.